I've been asked to share a typical day in the life of teaching from home. So obviously what I'll do is in this video I'm going to share everything that I do, everything that's been helping me personally. I start the day with this stuff, bit of iron, bit of vitamins, bit of vitamin C, a good healthy breakfast, and of course a cup of tea.
So this is my office. This is where I do lots of work on my lovely Mac. Hubby's got a PC. Ugh. All about the Mac. So yeah, I do everything in here. It's kind of like my craft room. So as you can see, do a bit of crafting. This is kind of like therapy for me because I love sewing, I love making things, making some dolls and bits and bobs. Right guys, gonna show you my screen now, share all the pages that I get up on a morning. This is my setup. I use a headset and a little microphone. Let's get started. I'm gonna try to change the camera angle. How do I do that? No, I'm taking pictures of myself. Oh. Okay, so I log into Microsoft Teams. I tend to have my email open as well. I always have a tab for Pro Monitor. And now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna log into Google Hangouts. Okay, so we've got, as you can see here, lots and lots of threads. We've got one that's specifically for our staff members. We've got lessons in there as well. So these are for our specific group. So I normally sort of log on into the staff one, answer a few questions, see what's happening. So this is my personal log of all my activities, and it's pretty much got a log of everything that I've been doing since I've been at home. There's a variety of different things in here. There's things such as midpoint evaluations with students. We've got feedback sessions with myself and my fellow colleague Adil. And these are links to some of the video calls. There is a form that we're now filling in on Teams, which is helping our managers kind of keep a track of, you know, who's doing what, who's available, who's not. I don't actually work on Thursdays and Fridays, so those days are blocked out just to show that I'm unavailable those days. However, you know, for the rest of the time, it kind of gives you an option as to what you can kind of fill in. You've got one-to-one tutorials, marking assessment, classroom monitoring, etc. And I think something's pinging on my screen. Somebody's trying to ring me. This is John Stopforth. He's currently checking in on me to see how I am. Sorry, John, I didn't even pre-warn you. You're on camera right now. I've been asked to do a little vlog in the daily life of teaching at home. So this is John just checking in to say hi. He's always checking in on all the staff members and just making sure we're all good. But how are you today, John? Are you okay?
Well, I'm taking my little coffee break that I need to take because everybody needs to make sure that they're taking as much time as they can away from the computers.
Absolutely. Okay, guys, let's take break. See you back here in 30 minutes. So break time is not really break time when you've got a toddler. It's baby shark time. It is. Baby shark, baby shark. Half an hour later, it's still on. And we are back to work. Whew. Okay, so I'm gonna share my classroom because this is pretty much where students are collating their work, where I can log on and have a look at what they're doing and give them some feedback. Okay, so this is my year one classroom. So we've got a thread on here where we can post all sorts of resources, information, guidance, etc. This is a guidance from working from home. And then we've got classwork in here. They're currently on with their project called the Final Major Project. And all my students have got assigned a template that they're working within. So what I can basically do is I can choose the student who I want to have a look at. So for example, if I look at, let's have a look at Ashley. So we've got Ashley's work here. And if I click on open with docs, that will allow me to actually make some comments on Ashley's work. And at the top here, eventually we'll get some little
kind of icons to show who else is on the document other than me. So there's nobody logged in at the moment. Obviously, if students aren't logged in, we can see here that their icon hasn't appeared. If it's on there and it's got a pink circle around it, we know that they're active and they're working from home. And then obviously we can go through the document, we can add little comments and things like that. So many students will actually message me on Google Hangouts and just sort of say, Noreen, I've worked on some of the feedback points that you talked about in the last conversation we had. Can you check my work? Can you see if I'm on the right track? What I'm doing in order to track that interaction, other than my personal log, what I'm also doing is I'm putting a comment on ProMonitor in their folder just to show other members of staff that that student has made contact with myself. We have been in touch with them from college, and you know, they are working actively. So this is a Trello board that's been created by one of my students. A Trello board is really handy for kind of sticking sticky notes. It is literally like a physical sticky note that you're sticking onto a background. What he's done here is he's kind of planned his project out from beginning to end. We've got things like brainstorming activities, research activities. Each of these activities, when you click into them, little targets are set within the activities. Now, this particular student's been ticking them off as he's been going along. You can set time management stamps on there as well, so you can set like little mini deadlines for yourself. And this is pretty much how a lot of the second years are managing themselves, by using Trello, trying to encourage it with the first years now as well. But it's a fantastic app. There's the logo for it. You can just log on to trello.com. So I'm back downstairs for a short while. My hubby needs to use the office and make some video calls himself. So I've just had a quick clean up in my living room. I'm going to go back upstairs shortly, answer a few more emails. After that, I'm gonna go outside in the garden, try and get some fresh air. There's some lovely sunshine outside. I wanna take full advantage of that, get that vitamin D in. Hi everyone, I'm back in my office. So I've just come back to obviously check on a few emails and answer a few questions on the thread. So we've got a few students who couldn't log in this morning that have logged in this afternoon, and that's absolutely fine. And I was just discussing with my colleague Adil, who also teaches on media graphics, that I think we need to provide a little bit of flexibility, because not all our students can log on at the same time. Some are actually sharing computers with parents who are now working from home. There's some that just don't have any, you know, sort of access at all, and you know, we're managing to sort of keep in touch via phone calls. Hey everyone, so as you can see, it's been a busy day, been doing lots in and between working. Obviously it is really, really difficult when you're trying to balance being at home with your families and working at the same time. It is quite a challenge. However, I think the key thing is to be mindful that you're not spending too much time on the screen. Again, the students need to know that, you know, they're not supposed to be glued to their screens. It's really good to have those flexible working hours. And yeah, it's just good to kind of kick back and relax. So as at the moment, I'm going to put on a movie. My little girl is in bed at the moment. For those of you that are big Disney fans, Disney's available for $5.99 on Disney Plus. It's absolutely amazing. I've been loving it. Totally loving it. So basically, I'm going to chill now. I'm going to put my laptop away and I'm going to get my BB-8. And I've got a duvet here, a duvet, a blanket, and I'm gonna get on with a bit of Star Wars.